Hello. Hello. How is everybody? Are you ready? If you've been here before and watched me stream, I am obviously doing this at a different time. I thought I would change things up a little bit. I did take a couple of weeks off just to chill. Well, not really just to chill. More like regroup. So, I got some things done. Let me get my gloves on. Whoop. Hey, Jen, how are you doing? What's going on? I did change it so that there was some clarification, and Wednesdays are for drawing portraits, and Friday evenings are just for painting. The reason I'm doing that is because I'm working on a drawing book, drawing portraits, But I also have been really wanting to do some painting, so I didn't want to just limit myself. I got a little antsy. And good deal. Yes. I got a little antsy before we started. And so I did a value scale, which is always a good exercise, and a couple of shapes as if the light were shining on them. I didn't put any casting shadows, but it was something to get warmed up with. I also started sketching this out a little bit. I know you can see it. What do I do with my? I have my drawing things out here. Got an ebony pencil, a couple of charcoals. Couple of white, blending stump, a trusty mechanical pencil, and then this is just a Derwent. If you're drawing along on your own thing, it's fine, in my opinion, just to have a mechanical pencil and an eraser. I do have two kinds of erasers here. There's a kneaded eraser, and then there's this little bit heavier duty. The thing is about this one, this drawing that I want to do. This is a person that I went to school with, and I know she has a good sense of humor. So I'm going to go ahead and cover up this other side here, just so if I use charcoal or something, it won't migrate over on that area. And I've got my address covered up. This is just a scrap piece of paper that I got in the mail, and I started using it, as you can see, for this purpose. The thing is, let me show you the picture of this lovely woman. Thought this was very fitting. Laura's here. Hello. This is, I won't say her name, but those that know her. I went to high school with her. If anybody I went to high school with happens to see this, yes, that's who you think it is. She gave me permission to use this photo. She has a wonderful sense of humor, and she got a perm, and she decided to brush it out, and that was the result. So I thought this would make a really fun head study with the hair and her expression. So I don't want this to be an exact copy of the photo. So I want this to have more expression to it than that. Laura's being a slug on the couch. Oh, you don't feel good. Bummer. It doesn't look very clean, does it? It's been well used. I'm repurposing. See? And I know you can see some of the little markings here. Usually I start out with the mechanical pencil, And what I'll do, and I'm going to take my mug off of there. So I'm not distracting. Yeah, you'd really like her. She's cool. She's one of those people that people are just blessed to know. She's awesome. So what I usually do is I use a mechanical pencil and I'll kind of mark where I want the top of the head. And I know I've already made some marks here, but I'm going to explain them just for educational purposes, I guess, or for posterity. And once I kind of know where the top of her hair is, which there's a lot there, then I'll put like the top of the forehead. I'll decide where the eyes are going to go. And you can kind of see some marks going that way. And then her head is going until it gets down here, and then it goes whomp. And this helps me place some of these other shadows, and I just kind of make notes on where things go. And I'm going to go ahead and wipe that out so it's, because we know where it is. She's got these really deep expressions or deep marks in her eyes here and her forehead. I don't want this to be super tight, so this may not even take 2 hours to do, just even though I've got that amount of time slotted. And I do have my trusty mirror here, which is, I know it looks like it's seen better days, and it probably has. But irises. I kind of have already marked where her nose is. Side of her nose. Some of these shadows in here. And these are more like guidelines. They're not written in stone. And this is just pencil and paper. If it's not perfect, you know, I do want this to be a decent piece, but perspective, priorities. I'm trying to loosen up a little on my artwork, so this is bound to be, and I'm wearing gloves mainly because I've painted my nails. And I just don't want them to look nastier, because I will be using charcoal to get this hair part, because she's got that wild woman hair. Then what I'm going to do is start marking in the darkest darks. Lip. And you'll notice too, even with the expression, the center of her eye, because she is pretty much looking straight on, the center of the eye still lines up with the corner of the mouth. Same over here. There's about the width of an eye in between the two eyes. Feels really weird doing this with gloves. I haven't been using the gloves lately. Darkest darks. Let's get her. This would be a really fun head study to do in oil. You could really make some interesting marks. Friday, I will be doing oil painting, and it will be of a still life. There is an artist that I follow a lot on YouTube, and I've been studying other artist styles and finding out just kind of what I have fun doing. So you just kind of lose that sometimes. So anyway, Sandy Hester has some amazing, to me, still lifes that she's done. And I did a couple in my sketchbook of studies of hers. Granted, I know my style will not be just like hers, and I don't want it to be. But I'm going to do just a very basic still life in oils. On Friday evening. Same time. I'm trying this new time slot. We'll see how it goes. You'll notice this line right here in the side of her nose, it mimics this one also. And her lines there is not that. So the side of the nose lines up with the inside of the eye. Give or take. I turn the fan off in here and it's getting warm. If anybody has any questions, just pop them in the comments, and I will get to them. If you're on a replay, same. The great thing about drawing is it takes so few tools. We didn't have a lot of money when I was growing up, but we could afford notebook paper and a pencil. That wasn't breaking the bank. Had to happen for school anyway, so. Shadow right there. Just go to shadow right there. Since she's got a bit of a different expression on her face, I'm just making sure things are lining up on the in this area. I think I've got it a little off, but like I said, I don't want it to be exact this time. That's not my goal. Not that they're ever exact, but you know what I mean. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, I've got that a little far out. I'm going to keep your pencil marks light. Beginning, you don't want to be pressing into the paper really hard. That makes them difficult to erase. I've been working in another sketchbook that has having a brain fart. Has a heavier paper in it, and this one is a Stillman and Byrne Epsilon series. Paper's not quite as heavy as I like to be able to paint on if I'm going to paint in a sketchbook. Aw, oh, Jen, you're too kind. I swear, you two are so awesome. And it's looking very black and white there. There's not a lot of form yet. As far as like shapes. And her eyes real close here. I never realized we had the same color eyes. use this blender. Just very lightly go over this area. The still life is going to also have a different camera set up. I'm hoping there's not any major issues. Ooh, Poncho's getting wound up. Go ahead and I'll move to my ebony pencil. This is just a softer graphite. These are very versatile. A lot of the schools use these. Also, if you notice the nice sharp point I have there. That's because of my favorite pencil sharpener, which I always brag on. Gave her two nostrils on that side. I know she looks a little wild here, but she's only got one nostril on that side. Can't decide if I'm going to use charcoal on this or graphite on the hair. Hey, Poncho, they said hello. Where are you? Whoops. Oh, there he is. I think I should use graphite on it just to keep it I can already see she's looking much older in this photo, or this, not the photo, but in this drawing than she does. And she looks in real life. But like I said, we're gonna go with it. Going to accentuate her age marks. How's that? Yes, Jen, how's the writing going? Excuse me. Heather's here. Hello, Heather. This is a study of a woman that I went to high school with, that I'm friends with, that is, she got a perm in her hair, and she decided to brush it one day. And let's just say this is the reference photo I'm working from. Jen wrote 9,800 words yesterday. Yes. Go, Jen. I'm going to just kind of block this in her hair, and maybe I should. Yeah, I think I need to give it a darker background up here because she has very light hair. Especially on the top. Just an FYI, this is just blocking it in. It's not. The roughness is probably not how it's going to remain. The rough marks, that is. And because I am using this ebony pencil, I'll be able to manipulate it some. Because it is so soft. I did bring some vine charcoal with me. In case I decide to go that route, but right now, I think I'm just going to keep using what's in my hand. I haven't decided what the subject matter is going to be exactly, Friday. On the still life, I have some Halloween type props. Well, but they're also like classical. Like I've got a skull cast, and I've got a couple of crows. Some skeletons. Oh, let me take my. I was just catching up on some of the comments. Looks like they're having an interesting discussion. curly hair tends to run in my family. But now that I've gotten older, my hair is not curly anymore. So, this hairbrushed effect brings back some memories. Take my kneaded eraser in here some. Trying to give her hair a little form here. Kind of reminds me of my high school art teacher, too. Yeah, I think I've got this far. I've got this too far down. So I'm going to again, if you keep your marks light and not press, real hard at first, anyway. It makes that erasing much easier. Let me see. See things like that needing changed. So, has anybody here bought their Halloween candy yet? It's October the 5th when we're filming this. But I know myself, Halloween candy would not be safe. Hi, Mary. Thank you for being here. Let me. This helps soften some of the marks. I'm doing this fairly lightly also. She's just wearing a t-shirt here, so I wish I could. Halloween is a big holiday. For my grandkids' community. So I'm looking forward to it. Not that it isn't here, but where they live at, people don't drive their kids, there's so many. Parents just walk around with their kids. And remember last year there was a parent that was a neighbor. They were giving out small bottles of alcohol to all the parents, which I don't drink, but I just thought it was really neat that they the town did their my husband, my son-in-law is also a very, very big into Halloween decorations, very creative. I'm just doing some cross hatching here in the background. If you notice, first I went this way, I went that way with the, and now I'm going this way. because her hair is so wild, I don't feel like it should be real tight. I want to keep that. And I've got a white charcoal that I can use to go over. Some of these areas and pull out some of those really light spots show up. I'm just trying to make sure I have these lips the right shape. She looks pretty wicked there, doesn't she? I was just looking at the comments there. I think I've got this part. I've got her chin too. Yep, that helped. That looks more like her orneriness. Yeah, I almost didn't take the little bottle, and then I went back and got it and pass it so I could pass it on to somebody else. I figured it was such a cute idea. I think that was even the year my kids went and got me something, and I think I had one taste of it. It might have been a wine. What you doing, Poncho? Puppy by my feet. How many people are doing Inktober? Is anybody? I'm skipping it this year. No particular reason, just I had other goals that I needed to focus on. I've done it in the past. I haven't made sure I haven't. I had some ink in my one of my brush pens ready to go. Mean, it'll get used, but just not in that fashion. Think I'm going to change up to a two B charcoal and sharpen it tip of it just to excuse me. Used to encourage your teachers or your students to do that. That's cool. There's nothing like a really sharp pencil. Remember that line from You've Got Mail, Bouquet of Sharpened Pencils. Because I've changed the tone, I've added this in there. Gonna try and incorporate the two so it's not showing up so much on camera, but this is really light. A lot darker. You can really tell the difference between the charcoal and the. Tell your students to steal them all. try not to get too heavy-handed with this so it doesn't completely take over. Until I want it to. Yeah, I probably should have done the blocking in with this charcoal. Let me see how well that blooms. Yep. Moving this charcoal. I will not be leaving it this rough either. I should have used this to begin with. It won't stay this dark either. This vine charcoal is very malleable, and it will lighten it. Really, she kind of looks like one of the sisters here from The Simpsons with the hair. If anybody tells her that I said that, I'll deny it. Although I guess it's unrecorded, you know. I don't usually use a paintbrush with the charcoal, but I like what this is doing. Glad I had it handy. I don't like how crisp some of those edges are, so it's give it a different look here. And this will lift up really easily with this needle eraser too. Look like the wild woman. Melissa Power is going live right now. FYI, those interested in writing sprints. Not that I want anybody to leave. And it's 5 o'clock. Once mine's over, once this live is done, I probably will go wander toward hers. And some of these, this needs a little more depth on it. I've got a softer charcoal here too. That's a 6B. I think I'll go in and put some of these darker areas. Can't actually see this part of her hair in the photo reference, so we'll just invent it. Wild right there. wilder than I wanted. I decided to make this back really, really dark so I can. She's got a lot of like flyaways and things in this area with her hair. And by making this dark, I can go in and use the either the white or just lift it off. You can make your own vine charcoal too, by the way. If that's ever anyone's desire to do. I don't really like the look of the charcoal with the graphite. So why have I added more charcoal? I'm so glad you asked. Honestly, I don't know. I thought this would look more sinister, I guess, if I made it all black down here. Unfortunately, I know she's not going to kill me for making her look like this either. She kind of reminds me of Bette Midler in this one from Hocus Pocus. I've still got an hour left, too. That's good. I'm probably going to need it. Toodles. Bye, Heather. Have a great evening. It's not coming up. I'm marking with my pencil. My pencil is not marking very. It's more like scratching out the charcoal than it is marking. It's just not wanting to. I think it part of it is this paper, and I'm just trying to give it a little bit of more form in certain places. And that makes it look like she's got a caterpillar on the forehead. Get off there. Yeah, I hope everybody fared well with the all the hurricanes. Crazy. Crazy. I'm not going to sing it because we know how much YouTube likes that. Did y'all hear about Loretta Lynn? I know that has nothing to do with this, but honestly, I thought she had, I mean, I like her as much as anybody does. I thought she had already passed. I had a sister that was really into her. And my mother was too. I'm noticing, like, over here, this is not solid. There's some just trying to even out the tone up here a little bit. And some of these places where I made really wild marks. I know I'm not supposed to be going for I'm going to lighten that in here. Trying to get that. She's got some highlights on her lip where, pursing them right there, and I cannot get them with this pencil. Maybe. Reminds me too, I'd like to watch Hocus Pocus. Eyebrows are 30% of the expression on someone's face. And it's important to remember eyelids. Not just flat sheets of there's a slight thickness to them. Trying not to make the skin look too light so I can get some of these shadow marks to show up in there. Over her nose, there is a highlight. There's really nothing, no trick to drawing a face or a figure. It is just like drawing anything else. It's got shapes and form, value. Yeah, she was a pretty awesome individual, in my opinion. I know a number of her songs were banned from radio stations because of subject matter. She came out with one about the pill, and I don't know what all. Things that you just weren't supposed to be talking about on country music radio. I'm just kind of inventing this as I go along certain areas. I didn't realize she'd said that, or I guess I had forgotten. That sounds like her. I grew up in a small town in Kansas. In one year, she was the entertainment for the county fair that was held in our town. There's a picture of my sister who's passed away standing by her bus. And she had Loretta Lynn written across it. I really hope I have that picture somewhere. I know we had it at her funeral. Keep looking at the monitor for where to mess with. Get it too. I think I'm getting it a little too messy up here. My hair got straighter as I got older. I think it's a hormonal thing. No, I didn't. I didn't go. I know my sister did. I don't remember what I was doing. Oh, I think I was. That was back when I was waiting tables at a steakhouse, I believe. Those were wild years. So who knows what I was doing. Yes, I had some very wild years. I could elaborate, but I don't think you're here for that. Seems like she was well received. But did she have like a really strong work ethic, like she wouldn't have like cut the show short or anything, I would think. For no reason, or we had some interesting people come through for shows. Some of them better than others. To see where else I need to. I don't, like I said before, I don't want to have it too tight. It makes it look a little more like a sweater, but that's okay. I didn't have or I didn't seem like I did anyway, put it that way. It's amazing I'm alive. Some of the things. Between ADHD and number of other, I think she looks almost like cute in the monitor, and instead of kind of a nasty look on her face. Maybe it's just because I know who it is. She would not be nasty. If she's mean to you, you probably deserved it. think if I mess with it too much more, I'm gonna make it too persnickety. We don't want persnickety. Just a line right there. And she's got hair coming over her face right there. Nope. No persnickety. Maybe that needs, let's soften that up a little bit. She's got some. Trying to make her hair look a little more flyish up here, creating some that right there looks like a big clump, and it's not. I need to leave it alone. I think I'm gonna keep saying that, don't I? Look at it. We did watch the original Hocus Pocus the other day, the first one. I'm just kind of filling it in a little bit where my hand fell on this down in this corner. Made kind of an interesting texture, actually. Like right in here. I can't see it very well, but don't want to have like each individual hair, but I do want to give it a little bit of depth so her hair doesn't look flat. This is, I like some of these marks in here too. Got some lines like we all do this age. Yeah, I think we all need friends that would let us do a picture like this of them. Not be angry or offended. Trying to get that definite purse look on her face, you know, that, like, what the heck are you talking about type of a, what the hell happened to my hair? Just don't feel like I'm totally getting it. Oh well. I think it still looks kind of interesting. There's some cool marks in here. See, it almost looks like she has like really bright lipstick on or something. I need to leave it alone. Somebody tell me to leave it alone. Leave it alone. You're probably all yelling, saying, "Go back 5 minutes ago. Put that back." This writing here doesn't have any form. Needs a looks like it's a line going straight across. Okay, Laura. Laura said, but if I mark it right here, ooh, my hands are all gross from being in the gloves. This needs to not be so sharp of an edge. Come on, you wild woman, let's reveal what you really look like on here. I know to some people it may seem silly to put this tape on there, but for some reason it just, there's something about having that nice, clean edge on there. And I reuse this tape, I really do. I stick it on my table and then the next time I see that I can use this edge. Whoops. Oops.
You didn't see that one either.
Apparently I should have before I blown on it before I took it off, huh? I'll run it outside and put some fixative on it. Whatever you do, don't ever put hairspray on it. I've still heard people saying that. Not archival, it'll yellow, it makes it just awful. Okay, there is Miss Coffeeville, Kansas, 1982. I lose my camera. Come back. Come back. Come on. There it is. Let's see. Drawing demo. Oh my. 10/5/22. Oops, wrong way. Yeah, her lips are still too. Do you really? I saw you retracted that. Do you really? Or are you referring to yours truly? Oh, I was setting out to lighten the. Coffeeville used to be a really much bigger town until sadly there was a oil refinery accident And it was flooding, and someone, if I remember correctly, someone forgot to or didn't shut off a valve to one of the tanks, you know, that big round tanks that you see that are usually like white or gray oil. Either he didn't shut it off or the thing broke. I don't remember what it was exactly, but it got into the floodwaters that got into the community and just destroyed destroyed everything it came in contact with, essentially. It was bad, bad flood, and that compounded it. And some just hasn't bounced back from that. Really? Job with Hallmark in Coffeeville? There used to be like a Western publishing there. Or he did like the displays. Is that what he did? Ah, Shawnee. Okay. This. Okay, I'm gonna quit. I really quit. That's where it stands. This wild woman. I need to quit. Quit, 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 quit. But I want to keep messing with it. He did lots of OSHA and stuff. Oh, wow. That's kind of cool. His name wasn't... What's that? She's not a dentist, is she? I'm still trying to get that like scowl look on her face. A little more obvious. It doesn't, I don't think it translates very well. Okay, all. I think that's where I'm going to maybe not leave it because I see some. By the way, this drives my husband crazy when I do this. If I just touch that little bit up right there. And then, oh, if I had just... Her hair definitely looks wild. Thank you all for being here. I really appreciate you. I will be doing a live on Friday afternoon from 4 to 6. I'm trying to square that up in my camera-ish. Let's just get rid of the edge. There we go. Between 4 and 6. I think Scully just fell over. Yeah, maybe so. And I haven't looked at it from a lot of different angles or anything either. If I do continue to play with it, I will at some point put this as the thumbnail for this video. I'll see what my hubby says. He usually gets the... Yes, I have a live stream tomorrow afternoon for writing sprints, and then from 1 to 3 Central. And Friday. And I might go... No, I can't tomorrow. I went extra on Tuesday for my stream. Because I had some things I needed to get done. And that's not what I intended on doing there. And so I went about 2.5 extra hours. There's times I've thought about doing it like in the middle of the night. So, oh, thank you. Bye, Laura. Thank you for being here. You're so awesome. I'm going to possibly set this to the side and then come back and look at it in an hour or two, and then I'll put whatever I do decide is I'm walking away from, put it as the thumbnail. And I keep seeing stuff. Car appointment at 10:30. Yeah, you just never know. We'll keep it under control until you get there. No promises, though. It is 6:05 here, so I'm going to let you go. Again, I'm saying a Midwestern goodbye. Or I just keep going and keep going. Thank you for being here. I appreciate you all, and I hope to see you on one of the other streams. I will be here next week at the same time from 4 to 6 Central. And I hope to see you all then. Thank you for being here. Bye. Bye. Bye.